versatility as a lad or tied the magic and scoring 11 times in rebounds. caused Davis to miss 38 games. Next player, another Orlando Magic forward at that time, is Tobias Harris, who is now a member of the Detroit Pistons, I believe, and the back reads on April 10th, 2013 against Milwaukee. Nikola Vucevic recorded 30 points and 20 boards. Harris tallied 30 points and 19 rebounds in the same game. They became the first NBA teammates to have 30 plus points and 19 plus rebounds in the same game since New York's Willis Reed and Walt Bellamy in 1987. And we have a kind of special card because it is a rookie card from Orlando Magic guard Victor Oladipo, who is now a member of the Oklahoma City Thunder, and it is written, "The real rebuilding effort continues for Orlando. The selection with the number 2 pick of Oladipo, considered one of the most improved players in the nation, should speed up the process. The Magic have a lot to work within the Indiana star, as he's considered an elite athlete with a motto that never stops." So on the back, there's always something written like a fact, like the Harris one. So something that happened in one game, or maybe a conclusion, or a whole season, or like in Oladipo's case, because he has not yet played a single game in the NBA. Some general stuff about the player. So let's grab another bunch of cards. I have a few of the cards in a little bit in I don't know how to call it, some kind of extra package, because they are maybe a little bit cooler than the others. So collection, I can see the ones that are quote unquote special. This is Kevin Love, member of the Minnesota Timberwolves at that time, 2012. He is now a member of the Cleveland Cavaliers, NBA champion last season. So I thought this would be kind of a special card. His back reads, "Looking like an all-star right from the opening tip of 2011-2012, Love assembled a streak of 15 straight double-doubles to start the campaign. That was the longest such streak since Hakeem Olajuwon opened 1992-1993 with 13 consecutive double-doubles. Love could very well start off red hot again in 2012-2013. I always had trouble reading numbers in English. That's why I'm often struggling to read them, but I believe it's okay. Let's find another special card. Let's see what we got there. Here we have some. How about Hakeem Olajuwon? Centers ever played, and this is an original card from 1994, so I thought it would be a tiny bit special. On its back there are two sentences written. It's actually the same sentence, but one's in German and one's in English. Let's start with the English one. Olajuwon, who won the Maurice Pollard Love Trophy as the 1994 NBA Most Valuable Player, ranked among the NBA's top 10 in four categories for the fourth time in his NBA career. In German, Olajuwon, der die Maurice Pollard Love Trophy für den first time, winning a 0.606 rate in 2011-2012. Paul knows how to win over a city. Yeah, Chris Paul, one of the best point guards in the game, although there are a lot of good point guards in the association right now. Here is another Chris Paul. Semi-final series against the Thunder in 2014. Despite losing in six games, Paul had at least 17 points and 10 assists in each game. In a 101-99 win on May 11, he had 23 points and 10 assists. So players ever as well. Matching his Korea playoff high, James torched the Nets for 49 points to help the Heat win game 4 of their second round series in Brooklyn, 102-96. Now up to 4,419 career postseason points. The four-time MVP ranks 8th on the all-time postseason scoring list, just 38 points behind Jerry West. Yes, LeBron James, obviously, not everybody likes him, but he is one of the top players in the league. He's a superstar, no doubt about that. So let's grab another bunch and look what is in there as well. Special because it's Tim Duncan, who recently retired after the last season, but he is also, as Dirk Nowitzki, one of the best power forwards in the game. And I really like him. I like his personality, although I don't know him personal, but he seems like a great guy. The Spurs are franchise as well. I like Greg Popovich as well. I have him as well. So let's read Popovich's text. Popovich is the standard bearer for NBA coaches today. No active coach owns more championship rings or has overseen a longer run of excellence. Pop is the hands-on architect for a San Antonio franchise that's the envy and model for competitors within the NBA and across professional sport. So, and for the last one, let's read Tim Duncan's text. Duncan found the fountain of youth in 2011-2012. Despite playing the fewest minutes of his certain Hall of Fame career, the 15-year veteran saw scoring and rebounding numbers go up from the season before. Duncan serves as the foundation of the franchise. That's an annual NBA title contender. Yes, he is indeed, and they are indeed. So, I believe that's it for today. I hope if you are an NBA fan, then you quite enjoyed my nerd talk. And if you're nice time.